Hey Dee, it's Kendall Jenner. Welcome to my house. Come on in.
Hi, I'm Tommy Clements.
Hi, I'm Kathleen Clements.
Hi, I'm Waldo Fernandez.
We're here to talk about Kendall Jenner's LA home. Well, we got to know Kendall through
Chris.
Yeah, introduced to her through her mother, Chris.
She wanted everything to feel kind of comfortable and inviting so she could hang out in every room.
Tommy and Kathleen Clements and Waldo Fernandez did an insane job, and I'm so happy they're my best friends in the whole world. So
she was super involved.
Super involved. She came to every meeting.
Yep.
And right on time.
We saw really early on why she's as successful as she is in her business. If she had kind of, you know, homework, or if she had to give us notes about things that she needed in the house, she would come to the next meeting with a list of everything and pictures, and I mean, she was very on top of it.
Kind of the first thing when you walk in, I'm very proud of it, is my James Terrell. I have always wanted a James Terrell, so I was really excited when I got it.
Well, she actually got that when we were already kind of well into the design process. It can't just kind of go anywhere. There's a lot of prep and construction work that needs to happen ahead of time to, you know, set up for the work. He does have very specific installation guidelines. It is definitely very laid out and spelled out how he wants the work installed. There are a lot of kind of technical components that you have to be conscious of when you're putting one of these works in. And I think walking in and having that really beautiful, you know, light changing colors, it's really
amazing.
Yeah, it's really kind of beautiful.
This is my, I guess, formal living room. I made sure there was no TVs in here. So we get into a lot of deep talks in here. We actually hang out in here more than I thought I would.
That's the whole point, that you want a home to be used and enjoyed, and you're not designing to create a space that no one ever wants to sit in because it's too pretty.
We wanted to make very kind of calm and, you know, earth tones and, you know, more subdued and a little bit serene, so that it allowed the art to kind of really, you know, be the star and kind of pop out of its surroundings a little bit.
In the hallway on the way to my room, you have these two Barbara Krugers. I bought them a few years ago at Art Basel. They were actually my first probably really big piece of art that I ever bought, and this wall was just so perfect for them.
We refinished all the floors and did this really dark, beautiful, kind of rich espresso brown kind of color. Mounted the draperies high so it gave the room a lot of height.
If you bring the rods or the draperies as high as you can, the room's gonna look a lot higher than it is.
We really played up, I think, all of the arches that you see.
The Clements are so good at adding these little pieces that just make you feel really cozy, but also just are super chic.
We were really trying to activate the living room and make it a place where she would want to go and hang out instead of just, you know, walk by and look at it and think that it's pretty. And I think, you know, a lot of how we did that was with this kind of scale of the sofas, number one. You know, they're kind of really large, deep sofas. You know, the textures in the room, I think, are super inviting.
And then I have this really cool 1965 radio phonographo.
Having that record player there, it's a little bit of an experience hanging out in that space and putting on a record and, you know, the beautiful art that's up in that space. And it's just really kind of a mood.
And you kind of lead into this room, which I have now created into an art studio. This was a movie theater for like the first year that I lived here, but I had an idea. I was really stressed out. I was working a lot, and me and my friends used to just go in the backyard and paint. I was like, I do that all the time, and I don't really use this room as a theater so much, so I converted it, and I love it.
It was very dark as a theater. So, you know, we lightened up the walls and we did new draperies for her.
These are made from canvas. So I think one day I'm going to take these, I'm just going to paint over them.
We bought painter's drop cloths and washed it up so that it would soften up and hang beautifully.
Everything in here is made to become a mess.
But the idea was that you could just go in there and kind of go crazy and not have to worry about anything. And if paint splatters on the drapes, it's painter's drop cloth, so it doesn't matter. And the floor we did, it's actually a canvas as well. That's a painted kind of canvas, essentially floor cloth, that we had showed her an image of Cy Twombly's studio in Rome that had that beautiful tiled floor that she loved. And that was kind of the jumping off point for the kind of vibe of the studio.
This is my bar area. You always need a good bar. My mom is notorious for having the best bars.
The scale of it is nice. I mean, yeah. Again, I think creating these little nooks throughout the house that feel really intimate and, you know, kind of cozy, I think that was kind of, you know, the vibe that she was going for. I think a lot of home bars sometimes can feel like...
A little over the top.
And this feels very kind of subdued and a little bit understated, which I think is very Kendall.
Right off the bar is just a really nice kind of dark, moody powder room. This, though, is this massive stone sink that I was like dying for.
An old 18th century French kind of limestone trough that we found, and we thought it would be such an amazing moment in the powder room because she really wanted the powder room to feel like it was this experience.
The guy who did my house basically said it was the hardest part of the entire house was putting this in. They had to like try a million times because they had to like restructure the walls behind it and stuff. So this guy is probably never leaving this house.
It was a little bit of a challenge to install. It definitely has some weight to it, but I think, you know, the end result is so cool.
That's what we bring aboard too. It's all these good people that work all the, you know, all the time for us.
You want to make sure that, you know, there are talented people, you know, handling those kind of parts of the job because it really kind of makes or break the look of a house.
This is my office area.
The office is literally, when you walk into the house, you see it off to the left. So, I mean, it's very visible and, you know, you don't want to see a shredder and a printer and, you know, it had to be a cool looking space. And we felt like in the end, it turned out amazing. We found a beautiful vintage area rug and one of her favorite chairs is in the office. She loved the old fabric that was on it, and I think it just turned out great, but still really practical.
This is my dining room, which I love. There's a lot of woods in here. We kind of did this double rug thing, which I thought was really cool, and it warms up the room a lot.
The antique that we layered on top, that actually was something that came a little bit later. And I think the idea with, you know, what we tried to create for Kendall and what she really wanted is a space that she could always kind of add to and keep collecting and keep pulling in pieces that had meaning for her or that she finds or that she loves. And that's really kind of the, I think, vibe of the house overall. It doesn't feel overly designed or decorated.
Mixing of the chairs.
Yeah, it feels very collected, which it is.
Me and my friends come in here actually more than I thought I would.
That's always the best compliment I think we can get is when someone says, every room in the house is so amazing, I don't know where I want to hang out because I want to hang out in every space.
Exactly.
This is most definitely the most used room in the house.
This was definitely Kendall, for sure. I completely remember when she came to a meeting and had the idea for like this really amazing kind of cucumber green kitchen. She had pulled an image that she loved and loved the color and wanted it to be just kind of, you know, this little pop in the house when you walk in. Once the paint color was settled, then we went out and found the marble, and I feel like the marble kind of took it to a new level. That really beautiful kind of boggly marble is amazing. And then I think all the little touches of the unlacquered brass fixtures, it's just a really chic kitchen.
This is my TV room, family room, whatever you want to call it. I have, you know, my really nice cloud couch. I feel like everyone has a cloud couch, but they really are the best.
I think the vintage textiles, again, the pillows on that sofa, I think I love those particular textiles. I think are really beautiful. And I loved, you know, the touches of vintage in that space. You know, the sofa obviously is just kind of a really streamlined, clean, upholstered sofa, but I feel like the interest of that room comes in through a lot of the vintage pieces. Like the, you know, the textiles, the, you know, antique carpet, the Pierre Gouriche lounge chair. I think those are the things that really kind of give that room its soul and character.
We watch games, we watch The Bachelor, we chill out, and then these doors all open really nicely and we go hang out up there. It's a nice little entertaining area.
There's a table of the family room that people could sit and eat, and then there's a fire pit around four comfortable chairs.
It's just nice to get fresh air, and like I said, I live in LA, so it's always sunny, and it's just the best.
I think in general, with the exterior of the home, it's not a super imposing, huge house. And we kind of really wanted to lean into the really charming aspects of the house and kind of play that up a little bit.
The whole house is pretty much a U-shape, so every room almost connects to the backyard, surrounded by a lot of nature, as you can probably hear, which I love.
We wanted it to feel loose and casual, and the same thing that we've said about the rest of the house, that we wanted all of the spaces to feel like places that she would want to hang out in.
We hang out here so much. I just got all these vintage quilts, so I'll just lay them all out on the grass, and me and my friends will come out here and just chill, meditate. I did a sound bath out here the other day. It was really so nice.
Even that front courtyard, which has, you know, that water feature and, you know, the potted plants and, you know, the Willy Ghoul chairs, and it's just a beautiful space.
So down here, technically these are two bedrooms, but I needed the space, so I kind of made these into like a fitting room, which I also kind of call my Hannah Montana room, and my glam room.
She had her kind of full, you know, glam room for her hair and makeup team to come in, a full room for, you know, fittings, that was kind of separated from the kind of main area of the house so that people could kind of come and go easily and didn't have to kind of disrupt, you know, her personal space.
There's a really nice door so my glam people can come in and out really easily and not have to walk through the whole house.
We built a platform for her to do all her
fittings. Yeah, it was really about the function, I think, with this space, is that, you know, she had to have the three-way mirror with integrated lighting, the platform for fittings, racks for all of her clothes. We had to make it as utilitarian as possible, but then also, you know, she wanted it to feel like it had a bit of a vibe to it.
And the paint and the draperies.
And the bar on the left side.
Yeah. And the lighting was very, very specific, of course.
There was a specific lighting system that she uses, that all the girls in the family use, that they love. So it was something that we had to install into the integrated lighting in the glam room. It has like a full spectrum of kind of color temperature that you can adjust to. So I think depending on the time of day, if it needs to be tweaked, it's something that you're able to kind of, you have flexibility.
And I can tell you, you look really good in it.
There's this first little sitting area when you walk in. I usually come in here and meditate, chill out, zone out.
That's one of my favorite rooms in the house, really, because I think it's just such a great little nook. And I just love the kind of way that the Tracy Emin neon kind of interacts with those, you know, 18th century Italian panels that her mother gave to her. It's such an interesting, weird kind of juxtaposition that ended up really working and being so beautiful. I feel like the reason that that room really works and that juxtaposition works is because she's got taste. She can pull it off. She's got style. It feels like it's kind of innate, and it's something that, you know, she's able to carry.
Right.
And I don't know if every person could.
This is my massive bed. I love it so much. Probably the most comfortable thing of all time. It's 9 feet by 8.5 feet, I believe, to give you a visual of how big it is.
It's like a basketball court.
She needs room for her and six.
Six is her dog's name, by
the way. Yeah. This is my double-sided fireplace.
A vendor of ours who we work with, who always has really amazing, beautiful kind of reclaimed architectural materials and old stone, he had this really fantastic pink slab of marble that gave that whole little fireplace scene a really nice moment, I think.
This might be one of the most structurally renovated parts of the whole house. I get a lot of love for my gold tub. I'd say at least 3 times a week I'm in this tub. It's my favorite ever.
That was something she came to the table with kind of early on. I think that was one of the driving factors that kind of led us to choose all of the unlacquered brass plumbing fixtures, because it
right.
kind of worked with that, you know, with that really kind of bright gold kind of tub. It's beautiful. I mean, I think it feels a little bit more traditional, the shape of it, which I think is kind of nice in this house especially. And it's definitely, you know, a moment. I feel like for me, I think it's making sure that a space feels like it's a reflection of the client. I think that's really the most important thing, because There's nothing more off-putting to me than walking into a space that doesn't feel like it matches the homeowner at all.
They hire you to bring out something that they themselves understand, but they don't know how to do it. The most important is when you leave and the client enjoy the house and they're happy.
The best results are always with clients who are trusting and who do listen. Right. I think we're very respectful in what we create for them, that we want it to be exactly what they want and how they like to live.